My name is Aimable Sibomana. I'm a physics teacher.
Ababiri bajya inama baruta umunani urasana, abajya inama Imana irabasanga, abakiranye neza barongera, abakinganye ingabo ntibakingana inyegamo. Nganaho byeze we, wibutse gukurikirana amasomo kuri Mashyuza TV. Mashyuza TV se yaba iri gutanga amasomo? Yewe, wowe aho uri hose, Mashyuza TV yongeye yaje n'inzobere kabuhariwe mu isomo ry'ubugenge, bamwe bita fizike. Abana bitegura ikizamini cya leta gisoza amashuri yisumbuye ndetse n'icyiciro rusange, yabateguriye kujya inyuza amasomo kuri sheni yayo ya Mashyuza TV. Mwese amasomo abagereho, hasigaye mwese nahanyu gutsinda fizike bizababera nk'ubufindo.
Today we are going to learn by material we choose in physique or physics laboratory. The material we are going to deal with it, we have barons, which is electronical barons. This is the electronical barons. And also we have the spring barons or dynamometer. We have materials which is electronical barons. This is electronical barons. And also we have what we call dynamometer. This is dynamometer or spring barons. When we say electronic barons, this is electronic barons. We use a barons when we measure mass. We use a barons when we measure mass. And then also we use dynamometer to measure weight. This is what we call dynamometer. When I say electronic barons and dynamometer, all of those are devices used in laboratory physics or in physics laboratory. We have also stopwatch. This stopwatch we use to measure timer, or when we need to measure timer, we use stopwatch. Stopwatch used to measure time. When we need to measure a voltage of a current, we use what we call a device called the voltmeter. This voltmeter also is a device used in physics laboratory. And also we have other device called the ammeter. We use this ammeter in physics laboratory. Ammeter used to measure the current in a laboratory. Suppose when we have the circuit, for measurement of current we use also ammeter. And we have variable resistor. This is also the device used in a laboratory, which called the variable resistor. We have other device called the micrometer screw gauge. This is the micrometer screw gauge. This micrometer screw gauge We use it to measure smaller length. Suppose when we need to know the smaller length or smaller diameter. This is also what we call vernier caliper. This vernier caliper used also to measure the smaller length. This is a device used to measure smaller length. And also we have meter. This meter is a device used to measure length or distance. This is the meter which concerns with the 100 centimeter used to measure length. And also we have this is called the Pyrex glass. This Pyrex glass we use to measure the volume. Suppose when we need to know the volume of water, we use the also this device. And also we have beaker. This beaker also used to measure the volume. All of those are the physics instrument laboratory. Here we have also switch. This switch used in electrical current. You know, when we open the circuit, the current not pass in the circuit. And when we close the circuit, the current pass through the circuit. And we have, this is the microscope, optical instrument. This device also we have in physics laboratory. I want to show you the difference between ammeter and voltmeter. For graduation of ammeter, inside we have A. Here this ammeter, the SI unit or standard of ammeter is ampere. This ampere is standard unit of current. Reason why this ammeter use the unit as ampere. The voltmeter we have inside the symbol of V. This V characteristics. This V characterizes the ammeter. Reason why inside the voltmeter we have V. The standard unit of voltage is volt. Reason why for device called the voltmeter we use V as volt. You see here we have what we call power supply. This instrument also used in physics laboratory. We have the test tube here. This is example of test tube. And also we have what we call, all of those are backup. Those are the devices used to measure the volume. Here we have what we call also this is the variable resistor. And we have this device, which is called galvanometer. This is spot reflecting galvanometer. This used in a resistance. And also, we have what we call the device used to electrolyze it. This is the device used to electrolyze the material. Suppose when we need to know cathode and anode, we use this device in electrolysis. All of those are the material used in physics. There is someone who doesn't know the manometer. I want to show you manometer. This is also manometer. Manometer is a device used to measure a pressure. This manometer is used to measure a pressure of liquid. Now today, also I am going to show you the difference between vector quantity. This is vector quantity. And the scalar quantity. You know vector quantity? When I say vector quantity, characterized by, magnitude and direction. Magnitude and direction. This is what we call vector quantities. When I say vector quantity, example, we have force, we have acceleration, we have velocity, we have displacement. We have momentum. We have electrical field. We have also magnetic field. And so on. All of those are examples of vector quantities. Before dealing with the vector quantities, we are going to say scalar quantity. When I say scalar quantity, characterized by magnitude only. Characterized by magnitude only. Is there any example of scalar quantity? Is there an example of scalar quantity? Yes! Example. We have speed. We have distance. We have energy. We have also length, pressure, power, density. Area, volume, and so on. These are examples of scalar quantities. After dealing with the scalar quantity and the vector quantity, we are going to deal with the distance and the displacement. Student, who can define distance and define displacement? Yes, distance is total path covered by a moving body. This is distance. Device used to measure distance is meter. Ruler. Suppose this is the way. When we need to cover, this is you have point A and you have point B. When we need to cover this total distance, suppose this A passed through there, someone covered the all total distance, means the moving body which one moves for this total distance, then it has mean this is distance. Now I'm going to teach you also this graph, this approximation. This approximation is a total path covered by a moving body with considering direction. This is the displacement. For instance, here we have this is point A and this is point B. When we need the displacement, we consider their direction. This is the direction. This is what we call displacement. This is a displacement. Now we are going to deal with the speed and velocity. Speed is the rate of change of distance. The speed is a rate of change of distance. Speed equals distance over time. Speed is scalar quantity. Speed unit is meter per second. This is the speed. When I say speed is distance over time, distance also is speed times time. And time equals distance over speed. Now we are going to deal with velocity. Velocity is the rate of change of this displacement. This is the displacement. Velocity is the vector quantity. Velocity equal acceleration times time. Or velocity equal initial velocity plus acceleration times also time. When I say acceleration equal velocity over time. SI unit, this is SI unit of velocity is meter per second. This is the SI unit of velocity, which is meter per second. I want to teach you also acceleration. Acceleration is a rate of change of velocity. This is what you call the acceleration. Acceleration equal change of velocity over change of time. This acceleration also it will be equal velocity final negative initial velocity over time final negative time initial, which gives us the change of velocity over change of time. This is what we call the velocity. Acceleration is the vector quantity. We have also deceleration or retardation. When I say deceleration is when acceleration is negative. Or deceleration by definition is the rate of decrease of velocity. This is the deceleration. Deceleration is negative acceleration. Called the deceleration or retardation. This is deceleration or retardation. Let me deal with a force. A force is push or pull that make an object. This is the definition of force. SI unit of force is the Newton. This is the Newton or F. This is the symbol of Newton. Force equal mass times acceleration. We know that acceleration equal velocity over time. We can write also the force is mass times velocity over time. This is also exist. We have many type. This is many type of force. For example, we have weight. This is example. We have weight. Have gravitation force. We have electrical force. We have magnetic force. We have tension and so on. This is the example of force. You know the force which is equal mass times acceleration. This formula show us second law. This is second law of Newton's. Second law of Newton. We say also after last. When I say after last, is upward, this is upward force. This is also type of a force. This is type of a force. A force is vector quantity. Characteristic of force are direction, application point, orientation, magnitude. These are the characteristics of a force. Characteristic of a force: direction, application point, orientation, and magnitude. Example. Find a force of an object which has a mass of 3 kilograms at acceleration, which is 2 meters per second squared. Solution. For a given mass is equal 3 kilograms. Acceleration is 2 meters per second squared. Force equal mass times acceleration. Force equals 3 times 2, which is equal 6 newton. This is the force which is equal 6 newton.